This is a fun study, a simple study, a study which basically evolves around the consumption, a small amount. Keep in mind, there's a sweet spot in reference to the amount to consume, no pun intended, of Adolfo mangoes. And the benefit to Adolfo mangoes in regard, or I should say in reference to the outcome of skin wrinkles. Not talking the appearance, we were actually talking skin wrinkles, is just astounding. So with no further ado, let us get right into the research as follows. And the title as being, Can Eating Mangoes Reduce Women's Facial Wrinkles? Again, we're not talking appearance, we're actually talking reduction of wrinkles, fine lines themselves. Mangoes, like other orange fruits and vegetables, are rich in beta carotene and provide antioxidants that may delay cell damage. A new study from researchers at the University of California, Davis, finds eating Adolfo mangoes, also known as honey or champagne mangoes, may have another benefit at reducing wrinkles in older women with fairer skin. For the dermatologists out there, Fitzpatrick score of 2 or 3. For those not familiar, women whose skin tends to burn a little easy. The study was published in the Journal of Nutrients, of course, with the full DOI and the link to this full study itself. But to proceed, here it is. Now keep in mind, it can't be too much of a good thing. We're going to get into that caveat in the full study after we read you this one particular line, which you see here. Postmenopausal women who ate a half a cup, 85 grams, of Adolfo mangoes 4 times a week saw a 23% decrease in deep wrinkles after just 2 months. I know it sounds like an infomercial, but it's not. It's an actual real study. Pilot study, 2 months, and a 20% decrease, of course, after 4 months. The randomized clinical pilot study involved 28 postmenopausal women, as we discussed before, Fitzpatrick skin types 2 or 3, skin that burns more easily than tans. Women were divided into 2 groups. 1 group consumed a half a cup of mangoes, 85 grams, 4 times a week for 4 months. That's like hardly anything. That's like using like the mangoes as a side dish or dessert. Another consumed a cup and a half, I believe it's 250 grams, for that same period of time. Facial wrinkles were evaluated using a high-resolution camera system. Before I proceed, you can consume too much of a good thing. And the hypothesis of why the 250 grams had an adverse effect, where the 85 grams, the half a cup of mangoes, had a very beneficial effect. But that's hypothesis. But to proceed. Quote, the system we used to analyze wrinkles allowed us to not just visualize wrinkles, but to quantify and measure, quoted the researcher. This is extremely accurate and allowed us to capture more than just the appearance of what the eye might see. So that's what I was trying to say. It's actually looking at the reduction of wrinkles themselves, not just the appearance. The study looked at the severity, length, and width of fine, deep, emerging wrinkles. The researcher said the group that consumed a half a cup of mangoes saw improvements in all categories. Now, this plays a huge role, too. A lot of people are wearing face coverings, and not to be too hypothetical, this could be a benefit in helping the skin tolerate those face coverings better. But to proceed, this is how they prepared them. This is important. Adolfo mangoes, fully ripe, fresh Adolfo mangoes, were washed, peeled, cut, portioned, and immediately frozen and stored at negative 20 degrees centigrade. Participants were given frozen mangoes prepackaged, this makes it so easy, into 85 grams or half a cup or 250 grams, cup and a half, don't do the 250 gram. Daily servings and instructed to store them frozen and consume 1 serving 4 times per week. Women could decide how to consume the mangoes, so not any really special restrictions. Just like I feel like mangoes. Oh, I'll eat one today, 4 times a week. As long as the fruit was not heated. Again, not heated, since cooking could lead to losses in ascorbic acid and other vitamins and so-called nutrients. On a read of the quote, this is why you can have too much of a good thing, and as alluded to before, a sweet spot in reference to Adolfo mango consumption. This is important. The reduction in wrinkles with 85 grams of mango intake may be due to the beneficial effects of carotenoids, flavonoids, and mangopharm, all of which as part of a whole food complex could lead to improvements in collagen bundles and a reduction in epidermal thickening as seen with animal studies prior. The increase in wrinkles, see, too much of a good thing, in the 250 gram group, cup and a half, was notable and unexpected. Now keep in mind, it had a very disadvantageous effect on wrinkles. But other health factors seem to improve just the same. But skin, not so much. Since a significant increase in the total sugar intake was noted in this group after 8 and 16 weeks, the increased sugar intake may have led to glycation of collagen fibers, thereby disrupting the collagen structure. Henceforth, that's the hypothesis, 85 grams, low amount of sugar, just right amount of nutrients, perfect for the skin. 250 grams, too much sugar, glycation kicks in, messes with the collagen fibers, not good. 85 grams, good. 250 grams, not so good. Now to conclude, the results from this pilot study support the concept that regular intake of modest amounts of mangoes may improve facial wrinkles. The apparent beneficial effects of mangoes on skin health may be lost if the intake of mangoes is particularly high. The effect of whole food intake on skin health are limited but promising. Further prospective studies are warranted. Again, even though a randomized trial, the study group was small, so I'd like to see a little bit larger study just the same. But however you think about it, that is just amazing. Just the simple consumption, even though the mangoes are frozen, at 85 grams, prepackaged 4 times per week, to have up to 23% reduction in wrinkles within just a couple of months. You can't, I mean, with all the people spend the money on skincare creams, so on and so forth, and other other treatments in reference to wrinkles itself, that's amazing. So, to conclude, Adolfo mangoes, 85 grams, fresh, not cooked, 4 times per week, incredible outcome in reference to skin health, and as well too, the DOI citation is there, linked to the full study, so you don't have to believe anything I say. You can look into research yourself to at least validate what I'm talking about currently. So, without being too off in reference to that, gratitude, thank you. Again, Adolfo mangoes, 85 grams, simple, don't cook it, and everything else should work out just fine. Except, I guess, the wrinkles. All right, catch you all later on. See you next week, and I look forward to seeing you then. Ralph signing off. Next time.